Tracking newly formed Tropical Depression 13. This just came about now. As of 11 a.m., we got the newest and the first update from the National Hurricane Center, where they were able to find enough evidence to find a well-defined center of circulation with this system. This is the same tropical wave we've been tracking for the past several days. It is now classified as a tropical depression with 35 mph max sustained winds. Currently, it should stay moving to the west-northwest there at 15 mph. Here is the latest forecast cone. You can see that movement west-northwesterly at 15 mph, where we are expecting strengthening as we head over the next several days. In fact, over the next 12 hours, we're anticipating this to become a tropical storm, where it will be taking the name Lee. And from there, additional strengthening into a hurricane is looking very likely, where it could be undergoing a period of rapid intensification. Notice by the weekend, we're anticipating a powerful and intense Category 4 hurricane. Now, the Leeward Islands will have to pay close attention to this track. This could make a dangerously close pass to them. But some good news here in Florida is the steering patterns are set up so that looks like it's going to take a curve to the north before reaching Florida. So I want to break this down for you. We currently are tracking the area of high pressure to the north of this system. That's what's going to block it from heading northward. So it'll keep it on this westerly track at first. And with that, we'll continue to watch it approach the Leeward Islands, the Lesser Antilles. But by the upcoming weekend, we're going to be tracking a dip in the jet stream, a trough of low pressure swinging across the eastern United States. That, along with the blocking area of high pressure, will essentially steer it, curve it out to the north and then away from Florida before it reaches us. So this is not going to be a threat to us. Here are those model plots showing pretty good agreement that it starts to make that turn to the north as it makes that close approach to the Leeward Islands. So we'll continue to keep an eye on it. But some good news right now is Florida is looking like we're in good shape, at least as far as this system goes. Elsewhere across the tropics, we have a couple more things that we're watching. We have the remnants of Franklin that have a low chance of actually redeveloping, not a worry to the United States. We also have this additional tropical wave that is just off the coast of Africa, 70% chance of becoming either a tropical depression or a storm. That'll be working its way off to the north and west, but models showcasing pretty good support that also will not be a worry to the United States and, in fact, should stay out at sea. So some good news there.